Hi guys, my name is Nicholas, and welcome to Real News Friday! Yay, where I report on better subjects of pop culture, and these are topics that I really know were trending, or topics that really captured my interest, and I can really give my opinion on, so let's get into it. Anyway, this is a big story that was like, everyone's like, oh my gosh, this really happened, and this is about a police officer who falcon punched this innocent lady that had nothing to do with whatsoever what's happening in the video, and then she was bleeding, and she got arrested for, like, just being in the wrong place at the wrong time. If you guys seen the video, as I have, there was just, like, a Puerto Rican festival, and everyone was, like, so, like, yeah, and I was, like, getting a little bit too rowdy, and then someone was, like, and was, like, you know, chilling, enjoying it, whatever, and all of a sudden, like, this bottle was, like, thrown behind her. I guess it was, like, a beer bottle, or, like, somebody threw water at the police, and the guy who got the water thrown on the beer bottle thrown at, he, like, turned around and, like, targeted the lady, and it was, like, all heck nah, it was, like, fucking punch, and, you know, she got knocked out, basically, and, you know, then she got arrested. But now, reports I've been really, you know, seeing about and hearing about that he could lose his job and could face criminal charges. 39-year-old Adia Guzmana, I'm not going to pronounce your last name or your first name, and for knocking her to the ground. Josie, a veteran in the Highway Patrol Division, could also be charged for the incident. And this was during the Puerto Rican Day Parade. And my opinion on this, like, why? I mean, I just felt so bad for the lady that really got punched. And the police station was, like, or the city was, like, going to sue her for, like, you know, being instigated. But, like, as they watched the video, like, oh, you know, that wasn't her. And we go ahead and pursue this. It's going to make us look bad. So they dropped the charges. But I'm just kind of like, I feel so sorry for Ireland, too, because, I don't know. It's just, like, during these days and times, you have to be really careful of, like, where you're at and, like, who you're around, because you can never know who can really get you in trouble or to a fist to the face. So this guy, if you know, if you're out there celebrating this weekend, be careful, because you can never know who's your friend or who's your enemy. But China, there was a huge landslide that hit a primary school, and it killed at least 16 so far, and this was after a month after two earthquakes shook the area. Three people are still missing, and with the students, there's now a total of 18 of the missing and confirmed dead. And they had a really bad time, you know, in China due to the two earthquakes that shook the area and other surrounding areas on September 7th. And also, those earthquakes were actually at 5.6, which is, like, shocking. And also in May 2008, there was an earthquake. And so I'm like, oh, this makes me kind of sad because, you know, don't actually really have to go through that so much. So I hope that, you know, China, I hope that you get a break. And also, if you guys out there in China are watching this, I hope you guys are safe and well because, you know, I just hope you guys are okay. Also, the jobless U.S. Rates have tumbled down to low rates. And this is the first time it has been actually this low in 4 years, which surprised me. And also, there's, like, a big number. It's, like, 104,000 or somewhere around there. I'm not really good with numbers or really even saying them, so I'm sorry. My mind is just going crazy. But that's how much people were, like, on the payroll since last month. And 8,600 more jobs were created in the last 2 months. So, yay! But this has been the lowest since January 2009. But there's still more people that are still unemployed, and more people want this to be on a fast track. But after, you know, just going through so much after these last 4 years, and, you know, during, you know, Iraq, you know, and the World Trade Center, you know, things are slowly coming up and up. I know people want to be fast, so that way a lot of people can be employed and be to where we once were before all those events happened. But, you know, it just takes time and patience. And I know that a lot of people are saying that, oh, I'm going to, you know, get the person who gets the most jobs. But honestly, you know, just be patient and just, you know, try to go into some volunteer work or just find some places that you can, you know, tip away work. And you never know, that can actually get you into a job. So what do you actually think about this? Do you think that this is a good thing, or do you think it's a bad thing? So let me know your opinions in the comments down below. See, this story really shocked me. I'm kind of like, why wasn't this on the news? I had to actually look this up, and I saw it for myself. And Triton, or I'm sorry if I pronounced it wrong, in Triton High School, a student went to go see the principal because, you know, she saw inappropriate behavior between a student and teacher in, like, explicit text messages. And now they tried to cover this up, but this has been unraveled since probably about last month to about now. So everybody's just finding about this now after it's been going on for a long time. The teachers in their late 20s and 30s, and yes, I didn't say teacher, I said teachers, so there are more than one involved people. They are accused of striking up relationships with female students during the 2011 and 2012 school year. Like, how could this go on for so long? Like who was bribed, or like, what the heck happened? Each of the five adults have been suspended from the school and could face at least 5 years each in prison if convicted. Now, my opinion of this, like, whoever tried to cover this up, like, it's just wrong, honestly, and this should have been revealed a long time ago. This should have been going on for almost a year or 2 years from now, if I got that correctly. I'm just kind of like, what the heck's going on? Why are these teachers sleeping with students? And usually it's always the females that, you know, are always, you know, the bad ones in this era. But these are five male teachers. Oh my gosh, like, how disgusting is that? Now, they try to claim that these kids were, like, 18 or already graduated. Like, if the evidence comes out that they're not, then you know what? They're screwed. So let me know what you guys comment about this. What do you really think about it? Do you think this is really disgusting, or do you think this is horrible? Or whatever your opinion is, let me know in the comments down below related to this story. Electronics, Samsung has claimed that they sold more than the iPhone 5, which is Apple's. They said they have sold at least a whopping 20 million Galaxy S3s, which is the new phone that it came out. You know, that looks really awesome, and that I really want. Hint, hello, you know, Samsung. But 20 million Galaxy S3 handsets globally in just 3 months. I'm kind of like, whoa! And that was in just the last quarter alone. Samsung shipped almost twice as many smartphones globally as Apple, 50 million in fact, compared to Apple's small 26 million, and total 1,706 million smartphones, or however you say that number, or 176 to be exact, million smartphones were shipped. Since there's no 1,000 or 100 in that sentence. Why I added in. And they were shipped in the last second quarter alone in 2012. Now, my opinion on this is like, what the heck? But, you know, it shouldn't really surprise me, because I feel like, you know, Apple isn't really doing their job. Because, like, when I saw the Apple 5, I was like, really? It's just the same phone, you know? Just bring up new phone. And it's adding, like, little special features. I'm kind of like, dude, that's lame. Why would I buy a phone just for that, you know? I'm just like, why even get it? But I think that the reason why people are buying the Galaxy S3 because that phone has such cool features on it than compared to the Apple 5. I mean, not the Apple 5, but iPhone 5. And there's just, like, a lot more new cool features, and, like, it's just totally updated, honestly, compared to the iPhone 5. I know that some people like the iPhone app because they like Apple, and I know like some people like the Galaxy S3 because they like Joy. So let me know, like, are you guys an Apple fan or are you a Joy fan? Let me know below. And also, if you're in the store and you were had purchased a Apple 5 or a Galaxy S3 and you had the money, let me know, what will you purchase? Let me know, people. The Converse, this whole freaking, like, Twitter storm and rage that people were like, tweeting about. And this is about Big Bird. And this is a comment about Mitt Romney that said about, you know, killing off, you know, PBS or killing off Sesame Street as a whole because of the way that, you know, of how much money that they were, that the government was putting towards, you know, in that specific channel or, you know, television series. And I know everyone, you know, knows about this, so if you don't, I'll go ahead and link you the story just in case you don't know it. And my opinion on this is just, what? Like, I don't understand why a lot of people are, like, freaking out over this, honestly, because I grew up more on the Mattress School Bus and more on, like, Captain Planet, even though that's probably the 80s or the 90s. That's part of the 90s, and Rugrats, and, you know, etc. So I was never really into PBS, unless it was, like, Rainy Rabel. Rainy Rabel was, like, one of my favorites. So if I put my situation as if Rainy Rabel was going to go off the air, or if the Magic School Bus was going off the air, yeah, I would go ahead and be like, oh, heck no, that's my show. But it, honestly, it was going to help our economy, and it will help us get up to the next level for our education and for us to get more jobs and for us to get more people into jobs and, you know, just to really help the U.S. and to really help it keep growing, to keep expanding and keep being to where we were, but where we should be at 2013, then you know what? Yeah, I'll say, you know, we should go ahead and cut that off, because I feel like, you know, if TV shouldn't really be our more focal point or our focus or our more point to really go ahead and say, hey, I want that on the air. I'm like, what does that really do for you, honestly? And I don't know if you're, like, bomb these characters and really learn a lot of things from these characters. And I didn't learn something for Sesame Street, honestly, but I feel like, you know, there's always things like DVDs or books, and I feel like even though if it's not going to be on TV, it will totally be, you know, somewhere else like the internet, or just maybe a live TV series about it that can seem almost like television. But that's just my opinion. I'm not trying to be, like, harsh or, like, critical or really trying to hurt somebody's feelings if they're really into that show and I believe the more the fan base of the show. I'm not trying to say, you know what, if we gotta get rid of Sesame Street just for a little while to really help our economy, then you know what, why not? Because we really do need it now. And since we're like in the trillions of, you know, debt-wise, you know what, if I gotta do it without Sesame Street, or even, or God forbid, if I have to do it without Adventure Time for a while, or even, you know, The Walking Dead for a while, so that way our economy can grow and, you know, flourish and be awesome, then you know what? Why not? You know, I think we all have to sacrifice at some point. And I feel like, you know what, even though Sesame Street may not take in a lot of money from the government to really help their programs, or program, as I say, I feel like, you know, there are other ways to really get your buzz or your really, you know, familiarity. It's not like we're back in, you know, the 60s or the 50s, you know, where, you know, we can't really, you know, really, we didn't really have TV, honestly, and we didn't really have what we have today as DVDs or just really get, there are like a lot of available things that we can just get from TV, honestly, so I'm not sure why a lot of people are freaking about this, so let me know your opinions about this. Do you think you want to kill off Big Bird, or do you want Big Bird to stay alive and, you know, keep on walking down the street? I don't know if you guys get that reference. But anyways, this is Nicoletta Simmons, and this has been Real News Friday, which I do. I gather all the news that really catches my interest, and I do it on Friday only, so if you want to stay tuned just for Friday, go ahead and subscribe. And also, there is Pop Culture that I do twice. And I do it from Mondays through Thursdays. And also, I do Friday Friends on a Saturday show, which I just really kind of talk about stuff, you know, you guys want me to do, or, you know, challenges, or just go over comments that people have been writing on here that really give me support, or any people that have been really negative. I already go ahead and, you know, give you guys a little spotlight and go ahead and, like, you know, give you back your own medicine. So, as I said again, my name is Nicola Simmons. This has been Real News Friday. And you know what? Enjoy your weekend and don't get in too much trouble. Bye, guys, and be safe.